With so many free agents currently on the market, it can be difficult to keep track. Although, there's also an aspect of free agency that doesn't receive much attention unless a huge star is in the headlines. This is the posting system. If you are not aware of this system, it is a player transfer system between MLB and NPB that allows Japanese teams to receive compensation for players who would like to play in MLB. This system has given MLB many big players, including Ichiro Suzuki, Yu Darvish, Masahiro Tanaka, and Shohei Ohtani. While some players' talents don't translate well to MLB, it's always exciting to see a big name from Japan ready to move to North America. In this current offseason, a few players have shown interest in joining MLB. The most notable name in that group is Tomoyuki Sugano. Today, I would like to talk about Sugano's career in Japan and what to expect in his forthcoming MLB tenure. Get ready for some mispronunciation. Sugano was drafted in the 2011 draft by the Hokkaido Nippon Ham Fighters, although there was some controversy with this selection. You see, the draft system in NPB is a bit different. The first round is entirely lottery-based. All 12 teams select a player they wish to negotiate with for their first selection. If only one team selects a player, they have the rights to that player. If multiple teams bid on the same player, then a random draw occurs where representatives pick cards and they are placed in an envelope. Whoever gets the winning card earns the ability to draft the player. One of the most notable cases is with Hideo Nomo in 1989, where 8 of the 12 teams drafted him, which is tied for the most teams to draft a player in the league's history. Now, back to Sugano. Sugano stated before the draft he wanted to be selected by the Yomiuri Giants and play under the guidance of his uncle, Tatsunori Hara, the manager of the Giants. Well, to the shock of Sugano, he was also selected by the Ham Fighters, who would end up winning his draft rights. Sugano would actually sit the season and wait for the draft the following year. Sugano would receive his wish in 2012 as he was drafted by the Giants. Through his 8-season tenure with the team, Sugano has had a remarkable career. His career stats show a career of clear dominance. Apart from a bad spell in 2019, Sugano has shown through the years why he has received high praise, including Jim Leland after a 2017 World Baseball Classic game, saying how Sugano looked like a big league pitcher. In just his second season, Sugano was the MVP of the Central League, which is the equivalent of winning a National League or American League MVP. He also won the Sawamura Award in back-to-back seasons, which is the equivalent to the Cy Young Award. He's also a 6-time All-Star, 3-time Golden Glove recipient, and a Triple Crown winner back in 2018. He also pitched a no-hitter back in 2018. Now at 31 years old and coming off a bounce-back season, Sugano is ready to move on to greener pastures. So, how exactly does a player from NPB translate to MLB? Well, NPB is generally considered at a skill level between AAA and MLB. This is why players such as, legends such as Jabari Blash become very successful in Japan after mediocre runs in MLB. So, some players are not able to translate their skills to a completely new environment. This is why signing players from NPB is risky. However, when a player like Sugano, who holds nearly a decade of continuous success, is ready to make the jump, MLB teams will be ready to lay out some contracts. Of the 8 pitchers that have made that jump since 2010, I'd say that at least 6 of them have produced seasons to their set expectations. Kikuchi hasn't completely adapted quite yet, although his FIP in 2020 shows that he was extremely unlucky. As for Yamaguchi, he was just straight up terrible for the Blue Jays. So, given this history, what could MLB teams and fans expect from Sugano? Well, don't expect huge velocity numbers. His fastball sits in the early to mid 90s, not unexpected for a 31-year-old. He's definitely a control pitcher. He looks to hit corners of the strike zone, which has allowed him to have consistent walks per 9 and home runs per 9 rates throughout his career, apart from his unusual 2019 season. Sugano's best pitch is his slider, which is one of the best in Japan. He's so confident with this pitch that he threw 3-0 sliders in the World Baseball Classic against the USA team, a game where he performed very well overall against what was essentially an all-star lineup. He also throws a curveball, splitter, forkball, and a shooto, which is a pitch that tails to the pitcher's arm side, like a two-seamer. He doesn't throw hard, but he knows how to locate. However, if I had to showcase a negative, it would be some of the worrying trends through Sugano's career. Since 2014, his hard hit percentage has gradually increased. Also, his fly ball percentages have risen, while his ground ball percentages have declined. This is likely a reason why Sugano altered his delivery in 2020, which is unusual for a veteran pitcher to do. However, given his production in 2019, a readjustment was likely necessary. The main aspect of his delivery he altered was how he moved his torso at the beginning of his delivery. In this 2017 game in the World Baseball Classic, Sugano starts his delivery by facing the catcher. As his delivery begins, he moves his torso to the right, then he picks up his leg in the same motion, and finally, he makes the pitch. In 2020, he starts by facing the catcher, but then he moves his torso to the right as his feet are still facing the catcher. Notice the difference? It's safe to say this change worked, given the difference in performance between 2019 and 2020. Well, Sugano is projected as a mid-rotation starter for a contending team, likely as a number 3 or number 4 starter. Given how valuable a commodity pitching is and how top-heavy the free agent market currently is, Sugano provides a lot of value for a playoff team. And when you compare some of the notable pitchers that have also come over from Japan, Sugano is not too far off from the likes of Darvish and Tanaka. Any aspiring playoff team will be interested. I can't say where he will land, but I'm very interested to see what his contract will look like. Sugano is 31, so he won't receive a long-term deal like Darvish or Tanaka. But I think he will at least receive a 4-year deal, maybe even 5 years if there is a bidding war. The money will likely fall somewhere between $8 million and $11 million per season. This is notable because it will impact what Sugano's new team will have to pay his previous team as a posting fee. Overall, I'm very intrigued to see where Sugano signs and how he performs with his new MLB team. Will he adapt quickly like Tanaka, or struggle like Kikuchi? Only time will tell. What do you guys think about Sugano? Will he perform well in MLB? Who will he sign with? Leave your thoughts down in the comments. I hope you all enjoyed the video. Leave a like if you did, and for me having to go through Japanese YouTube to find highlights. And subscribe for more content just like this. Thanks for watching.